Today, I'll talk about the coral confrontation and generalization of derangement. This is joint work with Dong-Soo Kim in Heist, where in the morning, Professor Ajayi said, since we graduated this school, so she's paired, it'll be easy, but I was graduated here too, but I feel a little bit much more nervous. Please understand me. Okay. Here, we will introduce somebody. Let me introduce the lady one. Okay. Everyone, I think most of you know what is the lady one. The lady one is a permutation with a fixed point. For example, we have one line notation like here, and we can write the permutation in two line notations. And if we also can write the permutation as a cycle rotation. Then if we write a cycle rotation, then a derangement is a permutation without one cycle, no fixed point. Okay. Now, we are talking about a coral permutation, and we will discuss about the derangement of the coral permutation. So what is coral permutation? Actually, I expect that and talk about that, but I'll introduce you about what is coral permutation. Well, coral permutation is a permutation which having a coral element. For example, now consider permutation pi of these 9 elements here, and 1, 2, 3 is colored in red, and 4, 2, 6 is colored in blue, and so on. And we say that type of a color, like the here, is the partition of the 9, and with 3 color blocks of same size. Okay, so this is an arbitrary color. This is an example of arbitrary color permutation. It may have fixed point, and definitely it is monochromatic cycle. The cycle has just one color. Okay, this is a color permutation. And now I will introduce you some kind of generalized derangement. Okay. First, NFID, which means no fixed point when elements are rearranged in descending order in each color block. So consider the color permutation written in two-line notation. So we consider that this is on one block, red block, and blue block, and green block. So in this permutation is a color permutation, and it might have fixed point here, 9 and 2. But NFID means no fixed point in descending order. So in each block, we rearrange the number in descending order, like this. 1, 8, 4 change to 8, 4, 1, and 3, 6, 9 change to 9, 6, 3. So after rearranging in descending order, then in this permutation, we cannot find any fixed points. So this is a derangement. And this is the definition of NFID. And next, since we deal with descending order, so we can deal with ascending order too. So here's the definition. No fixed point when elements are rearranged in ascending order in each block. Like this. For each block, for example, 5 to 7, it's rearranged in ascending order, then there's no fixed point in this block. So this is an example of NFIA permutation. Okay, so since we can deal with descending and ascending, so we also do the mixed order. I mean, it doesn't mean that the order is arbitrary. Maybe the order is prescott. So for example, first block, we determine that first block should be ascending, and second block should be descending, or third block should be ascending, and so on. So if we prescribe the ascending or descending pattern, then we can determine whether a permutation is a mixed, no fixed point in mixed order. In this example, if we prescribe ascending, descending, ascending order, then if we rearrange the second line and the first block by ascending and descending on ascending, then if we have no fixed point in here, then this is the foundation which is no fixed point in this mixed order. Okay, so these three permutations are it is very common to see that I think for these two, three categories, it's much common to see the permutation written in two-line notations. Okay, and let's move on to other kind of generalization of the element. Here's an example, other things. Here is no fixed curve, which means that here, if we consider a permutation as a map from set from 1 to 9 to 1 to 9, then it means that the permutation send an element I to the other colors. Right? So there is no line, no column have the same color. So this is no fixed column. And if we write this permutation in a cycle rotation, then you can easily check that in cycle, the adjacent elements cannot have the same color. So this is no fixed color. And this is slightly generalization of the no fixed color. This is no monochromatic cycles, which means that as you can see, there might be a pattern which adjacent element can have the same color. As you can see, there is no cycle which all elements have the same color. Right? So, for example, okay, this is no monochromatic cycle. Definitely, this is not no fixed color because we have this kind of pattern. And here, it's very complex to determine it. I'll try to explain it. Evenly monochromatic cycle. So, in this category, the permutation may have a monochromatic cycle like this, over here, or here. For each color, one color, the total number of elements in monochromatic cycles, color must be even. For example, you can see in the red color, there are two monochromatic cycles, and the element contributed to these cycles is the number of elements is two, because it's one and three. So this is even. And here, in the green color, there is a one monochromatic cycle, and if there is just one monochromatic cycle, the elements contribute to the cycle is even number. So this is the definition of evenly monochromatic cycle. Okay, maybe you are very curious about that, why I introduce such kind of very complicated color permutations, and explaining by generic function, I'll try why I consider this kind of color permutations. Okay, before I mention the generic function, I should say that this one. And actually, no fixed point in ascending order, or no fixed point in descending order, or no fixed point in mixed order. here, you can see that there might be a fixed point, right? So actually, it's not a delangement. Also, here, an even monochrome cycle, so it might have a fixed point too. So these are not delangement in general. However, if each block of size equals 1, I mean, which means the, for each color, there is only one element for each color, then definitely all these 5 categories reduce to the usual delangement. So we use the notation delangement, even it's not a delangement in ups. Even it's not a delangement in color permutation, so we use the notation delangement. Okay. Then now, what I'm going to do is to find the hierarchy and find the exponential delta function for each number of each categories. So let me begin with the color permutation. So this is a permutation. There is no condition. Okay. So given a weak composition A of n, so here the number of elements is 9, and the composition is 3, 3, 3. So this is weak composition. Actually, some color, if we fix the number of colors k, in here we fix the red, brown, and red, blue, green color. We fix them, and some of colors might have no element on there. So A might be 5, 0, 4. It is okay. Anyway, so this is a weak composition. And let color permutation respect to the composition A, you know, the set of all color permutation in Sn. Then clear we have there's no condition on the here, so it's just n factorial. There's no condition. We just arrange the 9 element arbitrarily. So this is the number of CPA. Then definitely we can find the delta function, exponential delta function for this number. But here's some warning. In this situation, I'll try to find and I try to study the generic function which have k multivariables, and each variable xi trace the ith color. So if I try to deal with this kind of color permutation, then which is they have their 3 colors, so maybe the form of this generic function is 3 variables. And okay. And actually the lemma is very easy because since this is k times with better this is nothing but a multinomial coefficient. So this is so we have CRF. Right? So that's why we obtain the CRF with this lemma. So for color computation, for general function, it's like this. Okay, this is our basic building block of analyzing other kind of generalized derangement. Okay. Well, now we discuss first. We first discuss the no peak point in descending order. Here I replace, for example, here there is a curl punctuation, and it might have a fixed point, but if we rearrange it in each block in descending order, if there are no fixed point on them, then this is an FID derangement. So this is, as I said before, it's a kind of obvious notation, but I will use one. Okay, so let D to the NFID be with respect to a weakly composition A, the set of these numbers. So I give before we find the Janus function for this number, I will give some examples. I will give some enumerative examples. For example, where if n equals 6 and the composition A is 4 and 2, so there are two colors, and the first color has 4 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the second color has 2 elements, 5, 6, and after rearranging each block in descending order, so like this, in this case, there are no fixed point, right? There are no fixed points. So it means that the curl permutation which sorted this block arbitrarily and this block arbitrarily, then this is our case, NFID, because if we rearrange each block in descending order, there are no fixed points. And we can find, we will seek other case, different case which don't have this fixed point in descending order. So including this case, there are 3 and 7 cases. And so the number of this kind of derangement is 7 × 4, which means the shuffling of the first block, and 2, which is the shuffling of second block. So the number is 336. Actually, this is the motivation of our study, because this version, a slightly different version, actually, the previous researcher only studied that, not the exponential structure, so they count the number like as a 7, and they studied ordinary generic function. Anyway, since we'll shuffle each of them and we'll divide it into exponential parts, so maybe it's a exactly the same, it will be exactly the same generic function. Okay, and anyway, Han and Sin first consider the generic function for this kind of generalized arrangement. Actually, they proved it, not combinatorial, but they proved it using symmetric function. And they involve some operators and they calculate some top coefficient over them. And in the beginning of this year, Erickson et al. Published in the Electronic Journal of Communities that the more simpler proof explanation for the any function of these numbers. And also they ask that what will happen if the ascending order is used. Remarkably, it's very curious, but all the researchers considered in the descending cases, and no one dealt with ascending case at the time. So this is this is the motivation of my study. Anyway, this is the result. Okay, so the number of non-fixed point in descending order, the curl permutation, is the generic function, exponential generic function for this number is factored such nicely. And we can actually, the proof is by exponential, by normalizing exponential generated function, we can prove it very easily. Let's see. Here is me. Here we analyze this. Okay. Here is the arbitrary colored permutation. And maybe a factorial should be here, but we can definitely move it here. And then this is a colored permutation, such that each blocks are in descending order. Since I divided by a factorial, so I can make each block in descending order. And what this means? Also, this is an arbitrary no fixed point in descending orders, and since I factored it by a factorial, so this is also the descending order for each block. So let me show one example. So I transect one block. Okay. There's a block, 3, 4, 5, 6, and maybe there is if we order it in descending. Okay. There is a permutation contained in this class. So in each block, these two numbers have the same color, but there are no fixed point in here. But so this is in the no fixed point. And in here, there is a position where until here, this is since there is no fixed point, until here, this is an exceedance, and after that, this is a non-exceedance. So if we break it here, then we will insert a number. So the only number can be inserted is 5. Actually, 5 is inserted, and other numbers increased by 1. So 5 changed to 6, and 6 changed to 7. And here, and second row, the same. 8, 6 increased by 1, 9, 7, and 5 is inserted here, and these numbers not change because this is less than 5. So, I mean, so like way, in general case, if we arrange it in decreasing order, then there might be a no fixed point or at most have one fixed point, right? So in here, if we multiply by 1, then it represents we leave that block and have no fixed point. If we do anything, then this is multiplied by 1, and if we change this one, maybe if it's a second column, then we multiply it by x here. So likewise, so given a non-fixed point in descending order permutation, multiply by each block by 1 or just 1. If insert one element, then we can generate all arbitrary colored permutations. Okay. Have any questions? Okay. Now let's analyze the ascending order case. Here is an example. And let's D and no fixed point in ascending order, instead of all this kind of Delaney motion Sn. Then I will give an example 2. For n equals 6 and the decomposition is 4 and 2, then if I arrange it in each block in ascending order, then it's very hard to avoid fixed point. Anyway, there are four cases. Here, 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 here. Actually, if one equals located here, then there must be a fixed point. Okay, because one should be located here, so one should be located in the second block, and the same reason, six should be in the first block. Okay, since there are four ascending cases, so if we multiply by 4 factorial and 2 factorial shuffling each block, so we have this kind of this number of plane moments. Okay, and Wei and Steinhardt independently show the note independently find the exponential generic function for this case. Okay. The proof is almost same here. So I'll give you an example too. So since this is the ascending case, so if phi is an element in D and MD, no fixed in ascending order, then 1, 2, 6, 8. Okay. If the second block has in the second line is 1, 2, 6, 8, then where? There is no fixed point in here. And we have also have the same situation. There is a cut line which contains the after here, all the elements are exceedance because these are increased by just one, and this can be increased by arbitrary number. So we can cut in here, and in here we can insert a bunch of numbers. For example, we can insert three numbers, 5, 6, 7, and 5 should be increased by 3, 8, 6 should be changed to 9. And here, 1, 2, and 5, 6, 7, it should be a fixed point. And 6, 9, 11, right, like this. So here, arranged in ascending order, there might be not only one but also many fixed points in here, but the problem is that there should be a location which the varied location which the point integer should fixed point can be inserted. So the location is unique, like here and here. So in the unique position, we insert as much as element. Okay, so in the previous example, in the previous case, we can insert 0 or 1 fixed point, so we multiply it by 1 plus x I. And in this case, we can insert arbitrary number of fixed points, so in each block, we can multiply here like this. So this is the part of which the denominator, and this is the part in denominator here. We saw the function for non-fixed point in ascending order. Okay. So by analyzing generated function, we can find the generated function for this NFIA and NFID. And as we expected, it's not hard to find the general function for the mixed order. So in each case, if we prescribe each block is descending or ascending, then it's very easy to pop. So it is type of it is NFIM. example, here the first block is descending and second block is ascending. So descending, ascending. Here there are six cases which don't have, there's no fixed point. So the number of this category is like this. Okay. And we also can find the generic function for this case. For given number of blocks, we prescribe the subset H of subset H or subset of K. And here, elements are ordering ascending or descending each block in H. If the I is contained in H, then in the ith block is ascending order, and another block is descending order, then the generic function will be like this, because since we before, this is a general current permutation, generic function for general current permutation, and for H, for ascending order, for inserting fixed point in ascending block, you should multiply this one, and for insert fixed point in descending block, you should multiply this one. This is the answer for the no fixed point in mixed field order arrangements. Okay. Is there any questions? Okay. So this is the first part of our generation of delayment. And since each generic function is very factored very nicely and have the nice behavior, so we thought that there must be other class of current permutation which have same generic function. And if that class of derangement is nice, and if we deal with it more easily, then if we give a bijection between two objects, then we can understand the NHI classes more. So that's why we started to consider this kind of thing. Now, first, I will start with no monochromatic cycles. So in the cycle rotation, this is a current permutation, and if you write in cycle rotation, and if there is no cycle such that all the elements are the same color, then this is a non-monochromatic cycle. Yes. And here's an example. In this case, we should divide these four cases because there should be no monochromatic cycle. These two cycles, and one cycle, and if we sum of all them, then it's 192. And we found that the generic function of no monochromatic cycle is this. Surely, first we prove it in inductive way. We get some kind of signed reverse involution, but after some consideration, some sense of species manner, so we can really realize that it's very easy to understand it by exponential formula. Let me explain it. Here's the color permutation such that there are no monochromatic cycle. So actually this is a cycle which can be have arbitrary numbers. Okay? And in here we should subtract the monochromatic cycle. So this is a cycle have the only I colors, right? So it might have from I to K, the K colors. So if you subtract then the deck cars are only the non-monopoly cycles. Okay. So, and if we plug in these things, then we obtain this one. If we plug in this one, then we obtain two. So we can obtain the formula. Actually, so by the iterationary formula, we can explain this one. Now, let's see. This is a generic function for an FIA and no fixed point in ascending order and no monochromatic cycles. So this, since two generic functions are the same, definitely number of two sets will be the same. Then you may ask, is there a magic proof for them? Where we try to find, but until now we just find some kind of a little bit artificial bijection. It's an involution which involves involution principle here. So we, for each set, we give some kind of sign reverse involution, and such that for NFI, no fixed point in ascending order or no more cycles is a fixed point. And since we know the sign reverse involution and the bijection between the larger sets, so with this method we can prove it. So, okay, we can define an involution for this set. So by inversion principle, there is combinatorial bijection between these two sets. Where, but as you expected, the explicit description of this bijection is very hard. So I'd like to ask that maybe there must be a simple bijection. Combinatorial bijection between these two guys. Actually, I think this is a permutation which are preferred to written in one line notation or two line notation, and this is a permutation which are preferred to written in cycle notation. So maybe I think that most hard problems in the bijection between automobile permutation are the linear structure and cycle structure. So maybe we may, if one found the bijection, simple bijection between two guys, then we can find other generation of these kind of bijections. Okay, so yes, we have not yet found simple bijection between these two states. And since we deal with no fixed point in ascending order, so maybe there is a corresponding object to no fixed point in descending order. So it's a little bit artificial here, but we found that kind of, we construct that kind of object in color combination. This is an evenly monochromatic cycle. Here, even means the total number of elements in monochromatic cycle of each color must be even. So, as I said before, here, maybe we discard this kind of non-monochromatic cycle. We only consider the monochromatic cycle, and there are red colors only, and the two element is used to construct monochromatic cycle and monochromatic permutations. So this is a evenly monochromatic cycle delineant. Actually, as I said before, it may not be a delineant. We will use notation. And we here's an example. And we can also set the experience range function for this kind of objects. And this is the nothing border. Generate function for no fixed point in descending order. And anyway, the proof for this liberation of this formula is a little bit trickier than the no monochromatic cycle cases. Let me see. Here is the arbitrary. Here is the depth for cycle for arbitrary cycle. And here is a signed version. So if we plus here, then it implies that if there are the order sum of the monochromatic part, if the monochromatic part is the negative sign and the number is odd, the total number is odd, then it is cancelled. And if the total number of monochromatic cycle element in contained in monochromatic cycle is even, then the number might be twice. And note that there is a famous bijection between two colored even cycles. For each cycle, there are two colors. Then this there is bijection between this object and to the permutation of even number elements. I mean, here is a here contain it, this should the non-monochromatic part is the two colored equal cycles, and this can be changed the permutation on even number elements. So in here, even number each element means in the if we only focusing on the same color, then each color the number of elements is even. This is the same. So this is what we're looking for, this gain function. And if we probably solve this gain function, then we'll obtain, we can obtain this formula too. So this is a, we should use this bijection of domain, we can obtain this bijection and this gain function. Easily too. Now, so here, no fixed point in descending order and no evenly monochromatic cycle have Glazmont have the same generate function. So clearly, these two sets have the same cardinality, but as before, you cannot find a nice bijection. Often. So if we found first violation, the violation between NFIA and normal cycle, normal cycle, then we make with that violation you might find this violation too. Okay. So I discuss further directions where, so purpose, until now, I found two, some kind of generalized delirium set equinumerous by finding a exponential training function, but we should find discrete combinatorial variations. We found variation, it must be nice because for example, it is not easy to, for example, maybe it is easy. A generic function. Should be the same, right? This number should be same because formula is symmetric. So, but you can, it's very hard to find the bijection between these two sets. It's very hard to find. But if I found the bijection, more from these cycles. It's very easy because we just change the color, right? So maybe it's not all the case, but I think this object is much simpler, much understandable. So if we find the bijection between here, and we can understand many of the things on here. And just introduce no fixed point column, no fixed column, and which for example, this is the no fixed column because it's red and blue. Color, right? So generally, no fixed color is contained in no fixed point in ascending order or no fixed point in descending order because if there are no color in red here, so either we rearrange it in descending order or ascending order, there must be a no fixed point here. And technically, it contains color computation. So today's talk is from here we find the general function of this one from another direction from no fixed color. We can obtain this one too. Actually, since, as you know, if we found the general function for no fixed color, and it is closely related to linearized coefficient of Laguerre polynomial, and the general function is a little bit complicated. So, but if we know how to interchange them, if we construct from here and with some other factor, then we found no fixed point in ascending order, then since we know the general function for this object, so we can obtain no fixed color too. So maybe on Thursday, I'll talk about the relation between them. Anyway, since there is no time, I'll skip it today. And another direction is Q version. As I said before, since it is closely related to orthogonal polynomials, and there are lots of Q version for this situation. And so we can flow in the well-known result to our recent result. And finally, we found a kind of refinement for non-monopoly decided cases. Actually, it's not easy. It is easy to find a refinement because we know that the accidents, in the case of accidents, can track accidents for each cycle. So for each cycle, we plug in the accidents, and functions for all the polynomials because distance in a cycle is if you cut into fat in the cycle is the line, and the exercise is the nothing but can be descent or can be observed as a descent. So this is the descent number, and here we can find the with the statistics exercise. We define the general function for the non-monochromatic cycle, but we have not find the corresponding statistics in no fixed point in ascending order. Well, actually, if the object is in each block, if in each block is arranged in ascending order, we understand the structure. But since it is an exponential structure, so we should shuffle for each block. So maybe in that at that situation, we lost any information, so we have not found the corresponding statistics. Maybe we can plug in other statistics too. Yeah. Thanks for attention.
Are there any questions?